Welcome to today's match. I'm Jonathan Agnew, and it's a pleasure to be joining you today.
It's a gorgeous summer's day here, the crowd all suitably dressed, ready for watching a day of cricket in the sun. Joining me in the commentary box for this match is Tony Gregg. And you were out there earlier on, Greggy. How does the pitch look?
Well, thanks, Jonathan. The pitch will be very fast with plenty of bounce, so the fast bowlers and wrist spinners should particularly enjoy bowling on it. There's also plenty of runs out there if the batsmen can get themselves accustomed to the pace. I would certainly fancy steaming in on this pitch, as it should be pretty lively.
The captains are about to toss the coin, so let's get down there and see what happens. Looks like they'll be coming out to bat then. It'll be interesting to see if that was the right decision as the game progresses. There's a really good crowd in the ground today, and they'll be anticipating a great cricketing contest between these two sides. The players are on the pitch already, so play will soon be underway. Run there. Physical fitness is a major part of modern cricketers' training regime. What impact do you think this has had on the game?
Physical fitness as part of the modern game is obviously very important. You need to be fit, you play a lot. But you need to be cricket fit, and that's where I've got a little bit of a problem with some of the modern techniques. I reckon that fast bowlers need to be fit to bowl. They don't need to be fit to swim long distances in the pool, to run marathons. They need to be fit to bowl, and I think that we're seeing quite a lot of injuries as a result of some of the extramural work that is done by bowlers that doesn't involve the action of bowling. So I think that's a bit of a lesson to be learned. Having said that, I would be the last one who'd want to in any way detract from cricketers being fitter. I think that if you're fitter, you're going to be better.
Oh, great shot. That was superb placement.
Well, the bowler won't like that too much.
That's 8 off the over. No run taken off that ball. Great stop. Got ball. Maiden over. Fast bowler to start a new over.
That's the end of the fielding restrictions. Expect the captain to start changing things around now.
Edged. No runs there. Well, that's a cracking shot.
That's four all the way.
Wonderful shot. He really punished the bowler there.
No run taken off that ball. Beautifully played.
And a cracking shot, that one. He looks in fantastic form.
Going to come back for a second.
Better thrown, it could have been curtains for him.
And the end of the over. To many fans of the sport, reverse swing seems to be a fairly recent addition to the fast bowler's armoury. Was reverse swing a component of fast bowling when you were playing, Tony?
Reverse swing, while very controversial at the moment, has been around for a long time. I actually can remember getting the ball to reverse swing when I was a little boy at school. It wasn't anything to do with the way I handled the ball. It was, in fact, the ball had got old and was...
Out! Caught him! Let's take another look at that in replay. S- Serious pressure on the new man in them. Quality timing there.
The fielding captain will be a little concerned by that.
He really looks in good nick today. Batsmen are coming back for two. Two runs there. That's the end of another over.
At this stage of the match, on this wicket, the spinners should be doing most of the bowling.
Sent him back.
They're appealing.
Out.
You can't afford to lose wickets like that in top class cricket.
Let's look at that again. Real concentration required for the new batsman here. No runs there. Coming back for a second. Great timing.
He's cleared the infield with that one.
Everything was in the right place there. It fairly raced to the back.
That's cleared the infield, four runs.
He plays that shot really well and it brings him a lot of runs.
His captain won't be too happy with that. This is the last of his allotted overs.
Confident appeal. Out!
Brilliant fielding. That sort of thing can change the course of a match.
Let's have a look at the action replay. So, new batsman at the crease. He's got him.
Yet again, the batsman fails to follow the ball, and he's out.
That ball was travelling pretty quickly. He did well to cling onto it.
And from another angle. The new man in can't afford any lapses in concentration here. Oh, that's a cracking shot.
Found the gap there, and that races away for four.
Oh, that's a wonderful shot. He looks in great shape out there.
Another run onto the scoreboard. Two. Batsman.
That's a good shout.
He's calling for the TV replay on this one. Let's take a look at that from another angle.
They're tough ones for the umpire. We get to see it in slow motion or with Hawkeye over and over. But in the middle, they only get one shot at it at full speed.
There's the red light. He's out.
Well, they got themselves into a right mess there and paid the price.
Plenty of pressure on the new batsman then. One more onto the score. That's the end of another over. So, his final over then. What's the key to bowling with the new ball, Tony?
The key to bowling with the new ball is movement. There's no doubt about that. If you bowl a good length and line and you have some movement, then you're always going to cause problems for the batter. And the great bowlers, both of yesteryear and the modern fast bowlers, when using the new ball, get it to swing. So swinging the air is one way to move the ball. And, of course, the other way, with a new hard seam, you can move it off the seam as well. If you happen to be able to do both, well, that's a bonus. So for me, length and line and swing and seam is the way to go. But you can only do that if you keep the seam upright, and so that's the challenge.
Coming back for a second. That was good running by the batsman.
Gone again.
Let's take another look at that in replay. Absolute concentration required from the new man in. No run there, so they can't get it away. Another over gone. Seamato start a new over then. Lovely shot, right out of the middle.
On a pitch like this, I feel for the bowlers, there really is no margin for error.
That's another single there. Good bowling there from the seamer. Confident appeal. Out. Batsman's not happy with that decision. Not happy at all.
That was a vital wicket, as now the tail is exposed.
Let's look at that again. Let's have a look at that in Hawkeye. The tail's really exposed now. Well, that really was a fine piece of fielding. No runs scored. 6 runs off the over then. This will be the last of his allotted overs then. Tremendous timing. 6.
He might not have been quite to the pitch, but continued with the shot anyway and hit it miles.
That is a textbook shot.
Well, I reckon that's demoralizing for the bowler, but he needs to bounce back quickly.
Great shot.
He plays that shot really well and it brings him a lot of runs.
Batsmen are coming back for 2. Really quick scoring here. We know that climatic conditions. Confident appeal. That could be out. It is.
He was yards out there. That was a terrible run to take.
Let's take another look at that in replay. Tailender at the crease here. Poor bowling and terrible figures for the over. So, this is the final over. Second. Two runs onto the batsman's total. Top quality shot.
The bowler will definitely be out for some revenge after that one.
He's gone for it, and he gets six. He's scoring at a really good rate. Tremendous shot. He's gone for nothing. Let's have a look at the action replay. So into the tail now, and these lower order batsmen have got to show some resistance. That's another single there. Beautifully played.
Well, it was a bit fortunate there. It was a bit uppish, but luckily, to a fielder.
That brings the innings to a close. He's getting a polite round of applause as he makes his way to the pavilion.
These two opening batsmen really need to set the tone at the top of the order. If they lose wickets cheaply early on, it could lead to a collapse.
The fast bowler with the first over then. No one there. How important is it for a team to have an all-rounder these days, Tony?
Well, I might be a little bit biased, but I think that all-rounders have always been a vital part of the makeup of any team. The more of them you can have, the more batting depth you have and the more bowling depth you have. And, of course, all-rounders tend to be quite talented in all departments, and therefore they're not going to let you down in the field. So I think that even more so these days, the one-day game, for example, requires more batsmen, because that allows the top-end batsman to have...
Out! No, he's dropped it!
Good shot, and good stop too. He's keeping it very tight out there. Maiden over for the bowler. Right out of the top draw.
He picked his spot well there.
The bowler looks most unimpressed with it. Run rate's climbing now. Excellent stop. No run scored. That's a sensational shot.
Oh, what can I say? He looks in top form today.
Smashed for four. That's when we're coming back for two. Big shout. That's a suicidal run out.
Well, they got themselves into a right mess there and paid the price.
Let's look at that again. Sure, the new batsman will look to play himself in. Beautiful timing.
And a cracking shot, that one. He looks in fantastic form.
Expensive over indeed.
Fielding restrictions are over. The captain now has a free hand to position the field as he desires.
The ball just runs out into the covers. Tremendous shot.
Well, that's good batting. He might have hit it in the air, but it was pretty safe and got him 4 runs.
That's out. Cool.
He kept his eyes on the ball very well there.
From another angle. New batsman's in for the New Zealanders.
Oh, great shot.
His timing's perfect today.
Ooh, he really laid for that one.
Seven runs from the over. A medium pacer to start a new over. One ball to Sundries. Very good timing.
He's found the gap.
That's raced away through. No runs there. How important is concentration for a batsman?
Concentration is vital to a batsman. As soon as you start to lose it during an innings, then you'll get yourself into trouble and probably get yourself out.
He's cleared the infield with that one.
Well, the bowler won't like that too much.
Thank you. Nice shot. He's played that beautifully once more.
Everything was in the right place there. It fairly raced to the boundary.
Well, the bowlers are taking a bit of stick out there.
Captain needs to think about saving some overs from his best bowlers for the closing stages of the innings.
No run there, they simply can't get it away. Got away with it. He sent it. Confident appeal. That could be out. It is.
You can't afford to lose wickets like that in top class cricket.
Let's have a look at that from another angle. Absolute concentration required from the new man in. The ball just... He's put it down! Great stop. No run there. He's gone as well. Yet again, the batsman fails to follow the ball, and he's out.
Well, he picked the field around perfectly with that shot.
Let's take another look at that in replay. So, it's a left-right combination at the crease now. Excellent stop. No run taken off that ball. That's two from the over then. So, his final over then. He struck that really firmly. He's played that beautifully. Pure time. Glorious shot.
Wonderful shot. He really punished the bowler there.
No ball. No runs scored. Taken off that ball. 10 runs from that over. This will be the last of his allotted overs then. Control of line and length is pretty crucial to a bowler, isn't it, Tony?
Line and length is absolutely crucial to any bowler. If you don't bowl the right line and the right length, no matter how much you swing it, no matter how much you spin it, you will find yourself being dispatched, especially if the batsman's any good. So, yes, I think that that old habit or that old bit of advice that we used to be given, get a handkerchief out and put it in the area that you consider to be the right length and just practice away to establish that you've got it right, stands good now as it did then.
No runs there.
No ball.
One ball to Sundries. Batsman coming back for a second. Big appeal. The umpire isn't sure, so he's requesting the third umpire. And from another angle,
they're tough ones for the umpire. We get to see it in slow motion or with Hawkeye over and over. But in the middle, they only get one shot at it at full speed.
There's the signal, he's safe. Exquisite shot.
That was a cracking shot. He really got into position beautifully there.
What a superb shot. That was a mighty hit.
The bowler might just have to put a little extra into his next delivery.
Mix up. Oh, what's the umpire going to say about this one?
That's out.
Well, he certainly wasn't out in the middle for very long.
Look at that again. New batsman in. His captain won't be too happy with that. So, his final over there.
it's out. Caught.
The tail's exposed after that crucial breakthrough.
That's an important catch. He did well to hang on to it.
Let's take a look at that from another angle.
The tail's really exposed now. Are looking for two. Another two picked up there.
No ball.
No ball, bowl. No ball. So the run rate stands at just under 5 and over. And from another angle. New batsman in, an absolute concentration required now. Batsmen are coming back for two. They're having a shout. It looks like the third umpire has been called in on this one. Let's have a look at the action replay.
They're tough ones for the umpire. We get to see it in slow motion or with Hawkeye over and over. But in the middle, they only get one shot at it at full speed.
There's the signal. He's safe. Do you think pitches have improved since you were playing international cricket, Tony?
Yes, I think that there certainly are pitches that have improved quite dramatically since I was playing. Mind you, there are also quite a lot that have become pretty dead and definitely haven't improved. So it's a little hard to be general about pitches. One thing I do know, and that is that groundsmen around the world do know very clearly what the ICC considers to be a good pitch, and that is one which has some bounce, it has some carry, and
confident appeal. Gone again.
Well, they got themselves into a right mess there and paid the price.
Let's have a look at that from another angle. New batsman's in for the New Zealanders. Great shot. Who needs batting technique when he can hit the ball like that? Six runs. Batsmen are looking for two.
What's the umpire going to say about this one?
He's gone for nothing.
That about wraps it up now.
There might be a few heated words said about that in the changing room.
Let's have a look at the action replay. Real concentration required from the new batsman here. One more run there. Going to come back for two.
It's all over. Those are the winning runs.